Evening, everyone. Welcome to the regular meeting of council for December 4th. We're meeting on the traditional territory of the Squamish Nation. Hothan, Squalwin, please Tillicumuk, Loth, Squamish, Oemio. I'm looking for a motion to adopt a very brief but important agenda. Moved by Council French, seconded by Council Race. All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries. Any notice of motion? Seeing none. We do have a delegation here tonight. Amy Liebenberg, the new executive director of the East Squamish Arts Council. And Sydney Lyons, also with the Arts Council. Here's works. Just introduce yourselves and proceed.
Thank you. Thank you for having us tonight. I'm Sydney Lyons with the Squamish Arts Council, and
I'm Amy Liebenberg with Squamish Arts Council as well.
And we are here to request a letter of support from Council. We are in the midst of applying to a grant application to the BC Arts Council. Traditionally, the Arts Council has requested letters of support many times from the District of Squamish to support our various grant projects and initiatives with a vast amount of funders, and this is one of them.
Council, any questions? Seeing none, does anybody want to move? Moved by Councillor Schimmer, seconded by Councillor Hester. All those in favor? Carries unanimously. Good luck.
Okay, thank you. Will Councillor Anderson here? I guess not.
See how convincing you are?
Thank you.
All right. Consideration of unscheduled public attendance. Is there anybody who would like to speak to council tonight that cannot wait till the next regular business meeting? Seeing none, we'll move on. We don't have any public hearings tonight. So we'll move on to bylaws. Just one in front of us, which is the adoption of the District of Squamish Housing Agreement, number 2528-2018. Motion to adopt? Moved by Councilor Ray, seconded by Councilor Stoner. Any comments? All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries. I do want to pull some for minutes. It's some. Wait. That's not from here. Okay. So we've got a consent agenda in front of us for the minutes and correspondence listed here. Is there anything that council wants pulled? Councilor Race.
Yeah, thank you. 8-9. From the Trail Society.
Okay. Anything else, Council? Council Riggs?
Thank you. It's just actually
Wait, do I deal with that first or do I?
That would be dealt with under.
Sorry, Council Riggs.
I'll wait.
Seeing no other, I need a motion for the approval of the consent agenda, moved by Council French, seconded by Council Race. All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries. There's no late agenda items. There is a correspondence item, S. Stafford, regarding bike lanes, and there's a recommendation that the correspondence is referred to staff. And this is a bike lane on Queensway and Government Road.
Move that.
Moved by Councilor Stoner, seconded by Councilor Anderson. All those in favor? Did you have a comment?
Question.
I just wish to point out that since being elected, this is probably the single most talked about issue as I make my way about town. People mostly complaining they don't like this particular bike lane format on Queensway.
Yes, it is a pilot project, and so community feedback is welcome on this pilot project. That's how we learn. So I appreciate it. I hear it too. All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carried. Councillor Race, you had a letter that you wanted to discuss.
Well, I was just going to suggest we refer that letter to staff, and it's a letter concerning trails in the university area where there is, as most of us know, construction and planning going on, and so this is an appropriate time for staff to consider that in that process. So my recommendation, my motion, is that it be referred to staff.
Anyone seconding that motion? Seconded by Councilor French. Any questions, comments? All those in favor? Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. There's no approval of minutes. So, business arising from the minutes.
There is one motion.
That's not committee minutes and reports, mm-hmm. And I'm on 14.
No, but 13, approval of minutes?
I don't have anything on my agenda.
Recommendation.
Both the district paving
November
master plan. One came over the packet.
Right, it's different on here.
It's different. It must be two packages.
There we go. Thank you, Doug. I'm usually following my computer, which is the correct version. Okay, so there is, under approval of minutes, recommendation from the November 27th, 2018 Committee of the Whole, the District Paving Master Plan, that the District of Squamish endorsed the Tetra Tech Pavement Management System Study as the new District of Squamish Pavement Master Plan. Moved by Councilor French, seconded by Councilor Herford. All those in favor? All those motion carries. Thank you. All right. Now, business arising from minutes. Any business arising, Council? I have one. I will be bringing back for reconsideration DP 460, which was denied at the regular business meeting of November 20th, 2018. We cannot vote on this now due to the notice requirements to the affected properties that must be met. So I want to bring it back to the December 18th council meeting. And in order to officially receive the letter from the applicant, council would need to hold another hearing in order to accept the submission from the applicant. So we will bring it back on the 18th and hold another hearing and have another go at that DP. committee minutes and reports. We have minutes from the advisory design panel. And I noticed there was some missing information. Has that been corrected now?
I did ask Terry to fix that. Maybe what we'll do is we'll bring those minutes. Yeah, we'll just bring them to the next meeting.
Okay, so we won't approve these now. There was an item under the business where Jonas was describing the role of the ADP, but it wasn't captured what you said about them in the minutes version we had. It just said, Jonas spoke to the following points. I left it at that. So I think we need to include those.
A lot of points.
Or else it was a very short talk. So we'll bring those minutes back for approval at the next meeting. There's no council staff income announcements. There's no unscheduled public attendance. Open question period? Questions of clarification? Stephen, got anything for tonight?
No burning questions.
All right. Any council or staff announcements? Well, there was the Santa Claus parade, so maybe council members that were there might want to comment on that. Councilor French?
Yeah, I was there. So I'd like to acknowledge the District of Squamish staff who were involved in creating the float. I'm reluctant to get into names because I'll leave somebody out who deserves recognition. They know who they are, and they really did a great job. And I'll point out that there were three judges who were judging all the floats, and Jenna was one of them. The three judges determined that the best float, the number one float, was the Boy Scouts. And their float was basically exactly the same as the District of Squamish. So, in my mind, that makes us the unofficial number two float in the parade. Yeah, so it was extremely well attended from a public perspective. I think in the I've attended a number of Santa Claus parades, and that by far in all the parades that I've ever been involved with was the greatest number of floats and attendees. The great weather, I'm sure, helped out significantly. And bricks to the train company that sent a railroad train through the tracks at 3:45 and held up the entire event. I don't know that they deserve all of the criticism for delaying the parade, but nonetheless, it was effective. All in all, it was an excellent event, and I think Squamish should be proud of its Santa Claus parade.
Yeah. Excellent. Thank you, Council, for attending. Can I see a hand over here?
This morning, quite a few of us attended the Community Christmas Care event held at McDonald's, and it was amazing to see truckloads of toys and food being dropped off by just citizens of Squamish. There's also people just driving up and handing cash out the window just to contribute. And speaking with the organizers, they have they feel that they currently will be able to help more people in the community than they have applications at this point. So I don't know how this message will get out, and they've already started with their radio plugs, but for the people that are having a hard time as they're looking at their Christmas planning now, I would encourage them to reach out, and I think it's possible that everyone in Squamish will have a Merry Christmas this year.
Thank you, it's great work by the folks that put together that program. Our community is steps up when they need to step up. It was really a display of generosity this morning, that's for sure.
I almost forgot because there's so much happening. It's hard to keep track of where you've been. But 2 weekends ago, I went to the powwow at Totem Hall. And once again, it was just an absolutely incredible event. The dancing and the colors and the music and the sense of community. It was just a wonderful, wonderful event. And I think if you haven't been before, make sure it's in your calendar for next year. It's really a can't-miss event.
Thank you for that. I'd just like to thank Councilor Race for holding down the fort while I was away, taking a breather, and I really appreciate it. I had some very positive feedback in your role as acting mayor. So anyway, I know it was a lot to do, and I thank you for that. If there's no other announcements, I'll entertain a motion to close. Moved by Councilor Race. Councilor Stoner, all those in favor? Motion carries.